Watch your heads! The bigger they are, easier they are to target.
Never had your kneecaps broken!
catch! Thing about slings, they hide well.
Fishing in the moat? Oh, dead. Thank you. Is today the day?
Fear not. We shall achieve our goal.
Feel any burning? See a local healer or wise woman.
The bigger they are, easier they are to target.
I only loot corpses, except sometimes they're quite fresh.
You can try to win them all, but you won't.
Can use this. Not sure for what it's yet.
Thing about slings, they hide well.
Thank you.
take any more.
Stop your yapping and start digging.
One bullet's all I need. Give me a target.
Abelist at your command. I'm a war saving.
Maria!
One bolt's all I need.
Give me a time. Abelist at your command.
The Lyrians marched in silence, too tired to keep in step with the drums. Suddenly, the wind rose to a howl, and there was a loud crash of thunder.
Blast!
Meve leapt from her saddle.
We camp here. Pitch the tents, quickly! Quickly!
As the soldiers rushed to unload the wagons, a wall of water came down, soaking them to the bone. Later, they sat in their leaky tents, huddled, teeth chattering, violent coughs rocking their frames. The storm raged the night through, then finally passed before dawn. Meve emerged from her tent to wring out her coat. Reynard approached, his gait heavy, his face grim.
Your Majesty, several men of the 11th, a dozen or so, sought to flee last night. Sentries stopped and bound them. Now they await your judgment.
Meve fastened her still wet coat. She knew well why the men had tried to desert. They longed for their kin, had lost sight of victory, perhaps even no longer believed. Yet the marching and fighting seemed destined to go on forever. The Queen sympathized. She, too, was spent, and many doubts plagued her. Yet she knew the deserters had to be punished. The question was, to what extent? Meve entered the tent where the prisoners stood. Some of the men looked away, ashamed of their deed. Others raised their gazes to meet hers, their eyes red, tearful, pleading.
Yesterday, we were comrades in arms.
Meve said to the soldiers, bound at wrist and foot.
Today you stand before me as criminals I must judge. You well know how I deal with wrongdoers in wartime, without delay nor mercy. Sergeant, every third man to the scaffold, the others to be lashed. That's an order.
The sergeant led them out. Meve then heard them counting off. One, two, three. One, two, three. Some muffled weeping, the hiss and creak of ropes pulled taut, and then there was silence. As the Queen walked to her tent, she did not glance at the soldiers' bodies, though she sensed them swaying gently in the wind. She had done what had needed to be done.
Mom, I've come to tell you I must leave your army.
What? Why?
Against my better judgment, I joined you to heal your wounded. I realize now that was a mistake.
What exactly do you mean?
What you did runs counter to all my beliefs. You had your reasons, and have them still, I know. Yet I've no desire to abet them. I'd feel shame to lend a hand.
What can I do? Is there anything that would make you stay?
No, ma'am. Farewell.
So be it. Good luck and Godspeed, Isbel.